Hi, it's Jenna with Ashtonbee and welcome to another video. In today's video, I wanted to talk about something that is oh so relevant in my life right now. I just moved with my 20-month-old baby girl, and if I did it again, I would do it all completely different. See something walking behind me. It might be my cat Percy, and I'm so sorry about that.
You want to hang out there?
Okay. Oh no, you can't be there, sister. Purse. So I'm hoping that this video might help you if you're thinking of moving right now with a baby or a toddler. Okay. First tip: hire help. Please hire help, save your sanity, learn from me. I had thought because we had previously moved from apartment to another apartment, and in the past I've always moved everything by myself, so I just assumed I'll just do that again. It'll be no problem. Big mistake. One of us had to be watching our daughter at all times because she's little and she gets into everything. There was a few things playing against us and why I didn't really hire help. I thought we could do it ourselves. We were moving right by Christmas and the holidays, and so I just assumed everyone would be busy. And I also am the worst person for asking people for help. And we did end up getting help from my brother and my sister-in-law. They came up and brought their boys so they could play with my daughter, and we were able to actually move things that afternoon, and it was a lot easier. So, hire help. Save your sanity, save your time, just hire movers and make your life easier. The second tip that I would recommend is prioritize your packing. I started packing things up and I was quickly realizing that my daughter was starting to get a little freaked out why things were going in boxes and what was going on. So, I left her nursery and I left her toys to last so that she had the constant Audrey things around her and she would know that her stuff is still there. I packed all of our books and bookcases, I packed like our china, I packed all the things that we weren't using immediately first, and then I just like worked my way into what is most important and left her stuff until the very end, and it was the first thing we unpacked when we arrived at our new house. We didn't have to worry about it disrupting her schedule, her play too much, because obviously she's only 20 months old, so it's a little bit hard to sit her down and explain to her what exactly is happening and for her to totally grasp the situation. On a side note, I did involve her a little bit in packing, which worked out really well. She brought me books. We put them in the boxes, and then she helped me label the boxes, and while her labels didn't necessarily say books or fragile or for the kitchen, she had a good time with those crayons, and those boxes are now well decorated for the family member that I have passed them on to. So the third tip I'm going to give you is if you're in a situation sort of like I was, where we actually had an overlap with our new house and our previous place. Our schedules were insane. My husband's working full-time and going to school full-time, and I work full-time from home with my daughter, not in daycare, so she's home with me all day. And so our schedules are very hectic. So then throw packing and moving on top of that, near the holidays, we knew we were just going to burn out. So what we decided to do was that every night after work, we would drive over a carload of stuff so that we could start unpacking. That way, when we did the big move at the end, it was just big furniture and the last things that we just couldn't move before. And we would be mostly unpacked and we could just enjoy ourselves at the holidays. It worked pretty well. We were still really burnt out, but it made it a lot easier in the long run for us to not have to have a house full of boxes trying to find things with a toddler when you're looking for the thermometer because she's running a fever. So think about your schedule. Okay, so next tip, and I think is probably the most important, is do a walkthrough immediately when you get possession of your new house. In doing that walkthrough, I found so many things that could have been dangerous. For example, when I was cleaning, I had found an open container of like powdered toilet cleaner, and it was really terrifying to me. I have a cat and I have a child, and it was tucked behind the toilet and left open. If my daughter had gone in there and like threw that around, I don't like to think about it. It's just one of those things that it was like, why'd they leave that? And also, if I missed it, it could have been a problem. Another thing that I noticed was that they had a lot of those blinds still up that have the pull cords. I feel like I'd either have blinds on the floor for days, or I'm worried, of course, that my child would get tangled up in it. So just make sure you do a full walkthrough of your new place and take away any potential dangers or address any potential dangers before you start bringing things in, and just mitigate any situation where a child could get hurt. And finally, the last tip is the one that I needed someone to say to me, and that is, keep calm and keep your cool. I was so overwhelmed when we were moving. I had my daughter, I didn't have a ton of help, we had horrible weather, it was snowing and freezing rain, and we were trying desperately to move, and I just was so overwhelmed. I remember we opened the truck and our truck was leaking at the front, so the whole front of our rental truck we couldn't really use because it was just leaking water like crazy, but the office wasn't open at this time, so we couldn't like return the truck. And I remember just standing in the back of the truck just crying because I was just so, overwhelmed,
overtired,
and just stressed out. Everything ended up working out, it just was way more stressful than it needed to be. And the other thing was, I stood in our apartment and I cried when it was empty. I feel like everybody sort of has some sentimental attachment to where they were living, but where we had lived in for the past 9 years, and it was a small apartment and it had seen us through every big milestone in our lives together. It was our first place we moved into together. We got engaged there. We had our baby and we had gone through these career changes and all these big things together. And it was just one of those moments where I stood there and I was like, oh my God, I was just a bit of a mess. But we got through it. And now we're in this house and we're still unpacking. I still wish we did it differently, but I'm really hoping that these tips helped you. Hire movers or get help. Make sure you prioritize your packing. Look for any potential dangers when you first move into your new home. Try and keep things a bit more structured for your child and keep them on schedule if you can. It is super hard. So on behalf of myself and Ashtonbee, I am so glad that you checked out this video. Best of luck with your future move, and I want to wish you the best day. Have a good one. Until our next video.